back to the Bass Lab. Today we're going to break down the disco classic I Will Survive by Gloria Gaynor. So let's get to it. While the song I Will Survive really only has one harmonic section, the bass player changes up his technique to make it energetic and dynamic throughout. We're going to break down each one of these techniques so you can practice them alone, and then you can put them together and make it sound just like the song. The first way we're going to approach the harmonic structure is just by playing the roots. And this is the way the intro starts. The bass player is simply playing the roots of each of the chords. Those chords are A, D, then G, then C, then F, then 2 on the note B, then slide up to E on 7, and open E, low E. If you were going to repeat this throughout the whole song, I would start on the low A rather than the high A that he plays in the intro. That would sound like this. This pattern will get you all the way through the song. After you've learned the roots, then you can begin to bring in the feel of disco. And we're going to do that by using octaves. So rather than just playing an A, we're going to use the octave above. I'm using pinky. So I have 5 on E and 7 on the D string. And I'm going to play a rhythm like this. So 1 low, 1 high, and then 2 lows. And I'll do that on each of the notes. This will give you a pretty good disco feel. Now that we've got the root and the octave going on, and a bit of a disco feel, all we have to do is add a couple passing notes in between those chords, and we'll get something that sounds like much of the track. Before each one of our low root notes, we're going to add 2 notes to walk up to the next one. So, after I play A, I'm walking up C, C sharp, and then the D. Then I'm walking up to G. Then I'm walking up to C. Up to F. Up to B. So, let's take a look at that up to speed. Now that we've got the main bass line, we can add some of the extras. You may notice as the song gets going, the bass player changes up the bass line slightly to make it a bit more rhythmic and a bit more exciting. He does this by raking through the strings to get a group of notes to sound quickly. It looks like this. So, I'm using my index finger to rake through 3 of the strings to get that rhythmic effect. Let's take a look just at the right hand. So when I add in that rake effect, we're going to get something like this. Now that you have most of the bass parts, you can go back to the original track and put them together to make them sound like the bass player is playing. Think about creating dynamics and creating a lot of energy as the song moves along. Here's a little extra credit part because it's a little riff that you might hear and you might want to emulate. I think it's pretty cool. So on G, he's going to do something a little extra. So first A. Here it is. It sounds something like this up to speed. Fun stuff. Well, that concludes our lesson on I Will Survive. I hope you learned to play it one step at a time. First, just the roots, then the roots and the octaves, then the roots, the octaves, and the passing notes, then the roots, the octaves, the passing notes, and the rake. And when you're up to it, try a little bit of that extra credit. I think you'll find it fun. Good luck.